Hello everyone, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 229. A new scam has come to light where cyber criminals are using Google Ads to steal cryptocurrency wallets. Scammers are placing ads at the top of the Google search that imitates popular wallet brands such as Phantom and MetaMask to trick users into giving up their crypto wallet passphrase and private key. This research was done by Checkpoint Research. Checkpoint Research in its blog post notes that to lure their victims, scammers placed Google Ads at the top of the Google search that imitated popular wallets and platforms. The company estimates that over $500,000 worth of crypto was stolen in a matter of days. Qualcomm is planning to conduct a tech summit on November 30th to December 2nd, 2021. Qualcomm is ready to launch a new Snapdragon processor, which is called as Snapdragon 898 processor, or we can expect some name change to this processor. WhatsApp users will soon get the ability to link devices without needing the smartphone to be online all the time. This feature to connect devices without the primary phone connected all the time is in beta stage. WhatsApp is still not allowing the use of this feature on tablets. Instagram is going to launch a new feature to its application called as badges and subscriptions. We can expect these changes to roll out very soon in India as well as rest of the world. The new Meta branding has begun showing up in all of the Facebook company applications, Instagram, WhatsApp, Facebook as well as Messenger. The Mark Zuckerberg owned company had last week announced that it was changing its name from Facebook to Meta, and now all these applications are now showing the Meta branding. WhatsApp, Instagram and Messenger used to show the text from Facebook at the bottom of the screen, but now these three applications as well as a Facebook application showing the text from Meta. This branding has changed for the application on both Android as well as iOS platforms. iPhone 13 screen replacement through a third-party repair shop would completely disable the Face ID functionality. A new investigation by iFixit reveals this is said to be a deliberate move by Apple in an attempt to stop iPhone users from going for third-party repairs. Amazon's Project Kuiper, a satellite-based internet service from low Earth orbit, plans to launch its first satellites in late 2022. The company has filed an experimental license application with the Federal Communication Commission to launch, deploy, and operate two prototype satellites. These satellites are called as KuiperSat-1 and KuiperSat-2. IQ9 is expected to launch in India in January 2022. IQ9 series would include two smartphones, IQ9 and IQ9 Legend. IQ9 Legend is reportedly to be powered by Snapdragon 898 chipset. It seems like Oppo is just deliberately trying to confuse everybody at this point. As we currently waiting for the Reno 7 series to drop sometime this month, the smartphone giant clearly has no intention of slowing down its constant rebranding and tiny specification iteration efforts. This time adding yet another member to the Reno 6 family, a leaked promo video showcases a Reno 6 Lite, apparently headed to Europe shortly and outlined most of its specification. The Oppo Reno 6 Lite is basically a rebranded version of Oppo F9. This device has been selling since April in India, which is pretty much identical to the Oppo F19. If we talk about the Oppo Reno 6 Lite specification, it comes with an AMOLED Full HD Plus display with punch hole camera. It will be having a 5000mAh battery with 33W fast charging support. It also comes with an in-display fingerprint scanner, Qualcomm Snapdragon processor with a 6GB of RAM and a 5GB of virtual RAM with a 128GB of ROM. Realme Vice President spoke about a new premium flagship offering from the company. The smartphone should be launched by early next year. Other high-end Realme products will also be launching early next year according to the report. Realme is working on its first phone with an under-display camera for some time now. Realme Vice President posted an image of a smartphone on Weibo that has no notch or a punch hole for the selfie camera, and he clarified in the post comments that the device does not come with a pop-up mechanism either, meaning it is using an under-display camera tech. In our recent interview with Realme's Madhav Seth, the pop-up selfie tech was also mentioned as a pretty unlikely to make a return. Premium smartphones nowadays comes with a powerful internals, making the device suitable for heavy or intensive tasks such as gaming. With increased performance, the company also need to take care of heat dissipation to ensure a smooth experience. In line with that, Xiaomi has today introduced a new heat dissipation technology called as Loop Liquid Cool technology. The company says that it is inspired by a cooling solution used in the aerospace industry. The Loop Liquid Cool technology utilizes a capillary effect which draws liquid cooling agents oxygen to the heat sources. Vaporizers send and disperse the heat efficiency towards a cooler area until the agent condenses and is captured via unidirectional closed loop channel. It reduces air passage resistance by 30% and the maximum heat transfer capacity is increased by up to 100%. Xiaomi is now aiming to bring this loop liquid cool technology to its product in the second half of next year. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.